Hi everyone and welcome to another How to Build tutorial. In this video I'm going to be showing you how to build 4 starter house ideas for 4 different biomes. These starter houses are builds that you should be able to build in the first few days of starting a new world. For the materials, I've chosen to use only materials that you can find in that biome. So, for example, in the forest I've used oak and birch, but in the desert I've mainly used sandstone. I really hope that you enjoy this video and find the builds useful for when you start a new world in Minecraft. If you're new here, please consider subscribing to see more content like this, and if you're already subscribed, then make sure you hit the notification bell so that you never miss a new video. So, let's begin with the forest starter house. Here's the floor plan. It should be 5 blocks across on all sides, missing out the corners. At the front, place 3 stripped oak logs on the first block, followed by an upside down oak stair and then 3 oak planks. After that, add oak stairs at the top and bottom to create a window, followed by 3 final stripped oak logs. Add an oak plank at the bottom of the doorway and an oak fence to the window space. On the side wall, use normal oak logs this time and mark out 2 window spaces using oak stairs and oak planks, as shown. Then add oak fences to the window spaces to finish it off. For the back wall, use stripped oak logs again and create 2 window spaces, just like we did at the side. And again, add oak fences to the window spaces. For the final side wall, create the 2 window spaces using normal oak logs again. And that's all of the walls completed. Now, starting at the front, add an oak slab on the top half of the top log with another on top and to the side, just like this. After that, create 2 more blocks, coming up by half a block each time until you're in line with the middle. Then repeat on the other side. So an oak slab on the top half of the log with another on top and to the side. Then a final block, half a block up, to join the 2 sides together. We're going to do this roof outline on all 4 sides of the house. They're all exactly the same. So, on the next side, do the same again, making sure that you start by placing the oak slab on the top half of the top log. If you get stuck at any point, feel free to look back at what you've already done or go back in the video to where I took you through it step by step. Once you've done all of the roof outlines, it should look like this. Now, come onto the roof, in the corner, and add 2 birch slabs between the oak slabs, so it's half a block higher than them. For the next 2 layers, do this again, coming up by half a block on each layer. The second layer should have 2 blocks, and the third should have 3, just like this. We're going to repeat this in all 4 corners. So head to the next one and do the same again, starting between the oak slabs at the bottom and coming up to the third layer. Again, it should come up by half a block on each layer and should look like this. Now fill in the last 2 corners in the exact same way. Don't worry if you get stuck, you can always look back at what you've already done or go back in the video. When all 4 corners are filled in, it should look like this. Now, on each side, add an extra 2 birch planks made using slabs in the middle of the third layer, just like this. Do this in each corner. These 2 extra blocks should be half a block above the third layer. Once you've done that, come to the top of the roof outline and make 2 blocks using oak slabs that come up by half a block each time, so they're half a block higher than the birch on either side of them, just like this. Do this on each side of the roof. Then fill in the space in the middle with more oak slabs, in line with the ones that we've just added. And that's the roof design completed. Here's what the house should look like so far. Now, to fill in the gap at the top of the wall, add a sideways facing log that's the same block type as what's been used in the wall. So stripped oak on the front and back and normal oak on the sides. Now that's done, we can start work on the interior of the build. To start, add a torch on the front wall to light it up outside. Then add a couple more inside too. Now remove all of the ground inside the house. Once that's done, add a border of oak planks around the outside. Then fill in the inside with birch planks. If you want to save on resources, you can use slabs placed on the top half of the block instead of planks here to make it a bit cheaper for you. For the ceiling, fill this in with oak slabs placed on the top half of the block at the top of the walls, as shown. Now on the back wall, remove the middle oak slab in the ceiling and the one directly above this in the roof, just like this. Then add some ladders leading up to this roof space and place a torch to light it up. Head back down and add an oak door to the doorway so no mobs walk in. Then decorate however you'd like. I've just added the essentials here, so a bed, chests, furnaces and a crafting table. I've kept the interiors very simple and just included what you'd need when starting a new world, but feel free to change them if you'd like. In the roof space, add some extra birch slabs to the corners to fill in the gaps, just like this. I'm doing this because when I was building this in a test world, some bats spawned when I left the spaces empty. After that, add a chest in front of the logs with a couple of barrels in each corner, so you have plenty of storage inside your starter house. And that's the interior completed. Like I said, I left this very simple, so feel free to change it if you want to. Now, to decorate the outside, I've added a leaf block in each corner of the house. You can get leaf blocks from any tree by breaking the leaves with a pair of shears. After that, create a small path coming from the doorway by right-clicking on the grass with a shovel. You can use any type of shovel for this. Finally, add a few flowers around the path to finish it off. And that's the forest starter house completed. The next house we're going to build is a river starter house, made using oak. To start, find a hill next to the river. This can be any hill, it doesn't have to be exactly the same as mine. Clear out a few layers so you have a flat surface to work on that's at least 5 blocks high. On the left, remove 3 blocks and fill them in with stripped oak logs, like this. Count across by 5 blocks and then do the same again on the 6th block. So you should now have something that looks like this. After that, remove all of the blocks between the two oak log columns, so you're left with a 5 block wide by 3 block tall gap. One block out and to the side of the first column, add another 3 block high column using stripped oak logs. Do this on both sides so there's now a 3 block gap. At the top of these logs, on either side, add an upside down oak stair, as shown. On top of the stair, add an oak slab, followed by a block, then add 2 more blocks made using slabs that come up by half a block each time. Then come back down to the other side, just like this. Then, in front of this, do the same but half a block lower. So the first slab of this arch will start on the top half of the upside down stair. It should look like this. Now, if you need to, tidy up the land on either side of the arch so there's smoother transitions, just like I'm doing. After that, come inside the arch and dig down by a block between the back columns, so it's 5 blocks across. Then continue to dig out a room that's 5 blocks across, 5 blocks high, and 6 blocks long on the sides. Here's the measurements for the left wall. We're going to remove all of the stone and dirt blocks that you can see here and add another column of stripped oak logs on the right-hand side, which is 5 blocks tall. It should look like this so far. For the columns on the left, add an extra stripped oak log at the bottom, but don't add one at the top, leave it as dirt. For the back wall, we want a 5 block gap between the columns, so remove all of the stone blocks from the right hand wall, just like we did on the left. Then add the 5 block high column of stripped oak logs to the corner. Here's what the back wall should look like. And here's what the right wall should look like. On the right, add the extra logs at the bottom, but leave the one at the top again. Now, in the gap between the columns, replace all of the stone blocks with oak planks. And add a couple of torches to light it up. On the back wall, do the same again, so replace all of the stone blocks with oak planks. If you're making your river starter house near a different biome with different wood types, then feel free to swap the oak for that. For example, you could use spruce or dark oak instead. For the wall on the left, remove all of the stone blocks again, but this time only add oak planks on each side and across the top, as this is where a mine entrance will go. Underneath the top planks, add two upside down oak stairs. Then you can start to dig out your mine. I've just left this very natural looking, apart from adding an extra oak plank at the bottom on each side. Remember to add a torch to light it up as well. Now, at the top of the columns where we left the dirt, add an upside down oak stair on each side. Do this at the top of all of the columns. If you want to save on resources, you can replace the stripped oak log that will now be hidden with cobblestone or dirt. For the ceiling, at the front, I break through to the surface, so I'm going to add stone brick slabs below the dirt here to cover it up. If you don't break through, replace the dirt with stone bricks instead. In the corner between the stairs, replace the dirt with a stone brick. Then, on the side between the stairs, do the same. Repeat this all the way around the room to create a border of stone bricks. After that, replace any remaining dirt in the ceiling with stone. I decided to use stone and stone bricks here, as you'll get a good amount of cobblestone from digging out the room, which we can then smelt and turn into stone and stone bricks. Once that's done, come to the front and replace the ground in between the front logs with stone bricks. Then add a row of stone brick slabs in front to create a step down into the room. After that, replace the stone in the floor between the log columns with stone bricks. Do this all the way around to create another border. Then replace any blocks that aren't stone, such as the andesite that I have, with stone, just like we did in the ceiling. Now, to make it safer, add two oak fences on each side of the entry with an oak fence gate in the middle, just like this. Then add a couple more fence gates at the entrance of the mine too, so nothing can come up from it. Now, on the right-hand wall, I'm going to move the middle oak planks back by a block to create a shelf within the wall. Add a couple of oak slabs at the top of it, and it should look like this. After that, add some stacked double chests with a couple of beds in front. Then, on the back wall, create a shelf using oak slabs and add some more chests on top. Then add a couple of furnaces, a crafting table, and another shelf with a chest on top. Finally, on either side of the mine entrance, add a chest. Don't forget to add some more torches at the tops of the columns on the other side too, so the room's well lit. Now, head outside and we're going to create a really simple dock. To do this, in line with the oak logs, add three sets of two oak slabs, as shown. Then, next to the last two rows, add more slabs coming across until you're in line with the other side of the arch. On the corner block, add an oak fence with a torch on top for lighting, and then add an oak boat so you can travel around easier. And that's the river starter house completed. The next starter house design that I'll be showing you is a desert starter house. To start, place a sandstone, a smooth sandstone, and a sandstone like this. Add an upside down sandstone stair at the top, then repeat the wall pattern again on the other side. Now, coming round to the left, missing out the corner, place alternating sandstone blocks and stairs as shown. There should be two stairs in total. After that, add smooth sandstone on top of the sandstone blocks, then repeat the alternating sandstone blocks and stairs across the top, but this time we'll have upside down stairs. Then add glass panes in the window spaces. Coming round to the back now, miss out the corner again and add a sandstone block, a stair and a block. On top of the blocks, add smooth sandstone, then repeat above with an upside down stair. Add a glass pane to the window space to finish it off. And you should have something that looks like this. At the front, come in by a block and mark out a one block window space, just like we did at the back. On top of this, add a smooth sandstone on either side with a normal sandstone in the middle. Then add a second one block window space on top of this. It should look like this. Finish it off by adding glass panes to the window spaces. Now come round to the right, missing out the corner, and do the exact same thing again. And again one more time at the back too. If you start in the desert, the best way to get wood is probably from shipwrecks. Once you've got some wood, you can make your tools. The best way I've found to get a lot of sandstone quickly and easily is by finding a surface cave in the desert. If the cave goes down by a few blocks, then all of the walls should be made out of sandstone, which you can then mine really easily. You should now have something that looks like this. Now, come inside the house and add smooth sandstone slabs on the top half of the block to create a ceiling, as shown. In the tower, leave the corner block on the right clear and add a ladder that leads up to the next floor. If you don't want to use so much smooth sandstone, feel free to use normal sandstone instead. Come on top of the ceiling we added and over to the tower. Add a sandstone on either side, followed by a smooth sandstone, then normal sandstone again with an upside down stair in the middle to create a doorway. Then add a smooth sandstone on either side with a normal sandstone in the middle to finish it off. Now on top of the walls, place a cut sandstone block on top of the normal sandstone blocks with a sandstone wall in between. Do this all the way around the top of the walls to create a balcony area. At the top of the tower, add smooth sandstone slabs on the top half of the block to fill in the ceiling. Then add the cut sandstone blocks and walls again around the top up here too. You can get cut sandstone by putting 4 sandstone in a square in a crafting table. To get the walls, put 6 sandstone in to get 6 walls. On top of the tower, add a torch to make sure nothing can spawn up there. Now it's time to work on the interior. So, come inside and replace all of the sand in the floor with smooth sandstone. Alternatively, you could just leave it as sand or use normal sandstone if you'd prefer. Make sure to add some torches inside so that it's well lit in here. Now, where the tower starts, add an upside down smooth sandstone stair on each side with smooth sandstone slabs across the top to create an arch. For the interior, I've just included the basics again, so feel free to change it. In the tower, add a bed and a chest. In the main room, add a crafting table, a furnace, and a couple of double chests. Head up the ladder and add a few chests up here too. You could also create some shelves to make a bit more room for storage up here if you'd like. Come out onto the balcony and add a torch, then add an oak door to the doorway. Come downstairs and add another oak door to the doorway down here too to finish it off. For some added decoration outside, I've just added a few cactuses to add a bit more colour. And that's the desert starter house completed. Now, the last design that we have left is the swamp starter house. To start, find some water in a swamp biome that's around 2 blocks deep and at least 15 blocks wide, so there's enough room to build. In the water, place 4 oak logs, as shown. On the 2 outer sides of the 3rd log, add a sideways facing log, just like this. Then, count across by 5 blocks and add 4 more oak logs on the 6th block, so there's a gap of 5 blocks in between. Then, on the outer sides of the 3rd log here, add the sideways facing logs again. Come round to the right and repeat this, so a gap of 5 blocks, then 4 logs with a sideways facing log on the outer sides. Then do this one more time for the final corner to create a square. And you should now have something that looks like this. Now, at the front, add three oak slabs coming out of the sideways log, just like this. Then, after the slabs, add two oak stairs leading into the water. Add a couple of upside down stairs beneath these to smooth out the underside of the staircase. Then add another two stairs that are in the water. This will be the way on and off the platform. On the other sides, add five oak slabs between the sideways facing logs, then fill in the middle. Make sure these slabs are placed on the top half of the block. You can test this by trying to place a block on top of them. If the block is floating, then the slab is in the wrong place. Once you've done that, at the front, add oak fences coming along the slabs between the logs. Do this on all sides. I've placed the fences like this so there's a bit more room to move around on the platform. For lighting, you can add a torch on top of each of the corner logs. Now, for the house, two blocks away from the front and three away from the sides, add three oak logs. Do this on both sides and add an upside down oak stair to the middle. So it should look like this. Now, come round to the right, skip the corner and add the three logs on each side again. But this time we'll add a stair at the top and bottom with an oak fence in the gap to create a window space. For the next two walls, do the same again. So skip the corner and create a window space. I've decided to use mostly oak for this build, as that's the tree that you can find in swamp biomes, so the easiest resource to get hold of. When all of the walls are done, it should look like this. Now, come inside the house and add an oak door to the doorway. Make sure to add a torch to light it up and create a ceiling using oak slabs placed on the top half of the block. Now, come back outside and we can start work on the roof. To do this, add a cobblestone slab on the top half of the oak log with another on top and to the side, just like this. Add another block, half a block up from this, then repeat on the other side. The roof outline should look like this. We're going to do this same roof outline on all four sides of the house. So, if you get stuck, you can look at what you've already done or go back in the video. I've mixed in a couple of mossy cobblestone slabs here too. You can get these by combining cobblestone with vines in a crafting table. To get vines, just break the ones hanging off trees with a pair of shears. When all of the roof outlines are done, it should look like this. Now, I wanted this build to feel overgrown and old because we're in the swamp. So, for the rest of the roof, I've filled it in using oak leaves. I filled in the first layer completely with oak leaves, and for the rest, I just placed them randomly, including a few extra hanging down over the roof outlines so it looks really overgrown. To get the leaves, break ones from the trees with a pair of shears, just like we did with the vines. Leaves are also great to use because mobs can't spawn on them. When you've done the roof, head inside the house and we can add the interior. Inside, I've just added a bed, a crafting table, a furnace, and a couple of chests. You can also add a boat outside so it's easier for you to get around. And that's all of the starter houses completed. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope that you've enjoyed this video. If you did, then I'd really appreciate it if you could leave a like or a comment with any feedback that you have about the video. If you're new here, then please consider subscribing to see more content like this. And if you're already subscribed, then hit the notification bell so that you never miss a new video.